Hello, I'm Milo Mills. I'm with Northside Music Company in Lafayette, Indiana. I'm going to tell you about some of the things to look for when you're shopping for a used piano. You know, there's a lot of pianos out there. Some of them are really nice, some of them are awful. And if you don't know very much about pianos, sometimes it's hard to tell the good ones from the bad ones. I've been to auctions where a piano that's worth several thousand dollars goes for $5. And I've likewise been to auctions where a piano that I wouldn't give $5 for has gone for several thousand dollars. So, first of all, we'll go through some of the sizes of pianos, so you have just the general terminology down. The piano I'm standing next to here is called a spinet. It refers to the height of it. Spinets are the shortest pianos. They were made most commonly from about 1940 through the 1980s. They're almost unheard of new today. It's a size that was very popular. People still come in looking for them, but they had troubles making them sound very good and play very well. There was a bit of a bias against them for a while because of that, but they're still popular because of their size. This is a console piano. It's a little bit taller. Quick and dirty things to look for without getting your tape measure out. The music rack, this piece, comes about even with the top, within an inch of the top, above or below. That's generally a console piano. The last piano we looked at, the spinet, the music rack stuck up above the top 3 or 4 inches. Okay, so this is just a little bit taller than the spinet. This is the common size piano made today in the world. This has been made for about 40 or 50 years, has been a common size piano. This is a studio piano. So the next size up again, studios. There are two forms of studios. There are institutional studios today, which is something similar to this. Well, this is kind of a light color, but it's something that is kind of designed to be bomb-proof. It's made for churches and schools, and something that the janitor can roll around without damaging it, but that plays nicely for someone who actually knows how to use it. And when they make an institutional studio, some of the things they do is they don't have music racks on them commonly, because that's something that can get broken off. They typically have locks on them, so you can keep kids out of them if you need to. And they typically have double caster rubber wheels, or full legs with toes, or both in this case, that make it easier to roll around and less likely to get damaged. But the height of this gives it a little better sound. Now, we also have decorator studios, which is something that is pretty, or sometimes the gloss black ones, but they're the same height as this. They give you the string length, but they're really not designed to be moved around. They're just giving you some better sounding piano, but still in a home version. But this is a studio. Okay, the last one we looked at was a studio. Now this is an upright. It's the tallest of the pianos. Uprights were, the current design of uprights came about in about the 1880s. And this size, this style, really kind of slowed down in the 40s when spinets became popular, but they still make full uprights. This is a brand new piano. This is considered a full upright, a professional upright they call it. And they make them, they like them still, because the strings are long enough that it sounds like smaller grand pianos. It has a really good sound to it. So this is a brand new instrument.